Since a few of you survived, yeah, after Jochen. No worries, this one is it's like it died in comparison to that. I already want to apologize when I use the wrong terms because I haven't studied IT, I don't know, I can't code. I'm pretty happy that I can use Windows, yeah. This Android phones is pretty difficult, but Apple works fine. You see here the logo Minusphere, so what MSG also does, what does Minusphere stands for? It stands for the MSG Innovation Sphere. Yeah? So it's a pretty new thing in the MSG. We have several labs, it's an innovation lab, and we do new innovations, disruptive business models. Basically the business of tomorrow, we are looking for what are possibilities, what we can all do. And I want to introduce you not the technique behind the word is, I want to give you the idea of the vision of the idea which we are following right now through, and what are the steps, and what is the problem we are trying to solve, which we're having recently in the world, we think, which will be a bigger topic in the future. What are the next steps we are doing to bring this on the market, and what are all the things we're not knowing? So hopefully it's the end of the short presentation, not as long, yeah? Maybe you have some ideas, because we have so many questions, we do not know how to answer all of them. So, right now, I have the feeling when I have a smartphone, I have a car, I have a toothbrush, I have a smartwatch, I have so many things. I have no idea what with my data happens. I don't know if you know the game with there's a wooden board, you have several nails in, you put the ball in the top end and it drops somewhere out. And I have this feeling this is what happens with my data. I don't know where it goes to. It goes to services, car manufacturers, insurances. I have no idea what happens with my data, which I generate in my daily life every day. Let us take the example, I buy a car. I go to the car dealer, I sign a contract, I give him money, several weeks later I get a car. Pretty straightforward process. If I buy an electric car, it's more or less the same. But I need to sign three contracts. Yeah? One for the battery, one for the car, this is BMW, it's also for the connected drive. I do not read the condition of terms, yeah? I want the car. There are so many pages, I have no idea what it stands, and I just sign, everything is fine, good for me. What happened here? The problem is, it feels like the page 127, there's a little box that tickets in, I give my data, all the rights of my data, I give to BMW, for example. I have no idea. Yeah? So I give my data, I'm actually the data owner, yeah? They're my data, I'm driving the car, I'm generating them, they are my data. I give them to the new owner. Again, he gets money, I sign the contract, later on I get, thanks God, my electric car. So what does with my data happen? I have no idea. This is just an assumption because I have no idea, yeah? But I assume, hey, the new data user is selling, giving my data away and gets a benefit from that, from the data user. He's getting money for it. So I generate data. I sign somewhere on page 127, it feels like, yeah, I give the rights of my data away, my data, someone else sells my data and gets money, and I get nothing. It seems to be not fair somehow, yeah? So what do I see which with my data happens? I don't see the money, that's for sure the only thing. What I only see is the tip of the iceberg, generally. And what is the tip of the iceberg? Everyone really knows it. Damn it, it's commercial. Yeah, the ads are the top of the tipping. Everyone knows it. Sometimes I have the feeling that you're like drowning, strangling in commercial, the flood. I don't know if you have the feeling, but 50, 60, 80% of the posts I get, of the emails I get, is just spam, commercial, by this, by that. I look on Amazon on things, later on I go on Google, yeah, I Google things, non-stop I get the ads, the pop-ups. Ooh, look here, these shoes or this watch, buy me here. Some are really good of the ads. I had a flat tire on my car, so I got a lot of wheels and new tires recommended. One was smarter, they said already I need the lift to lift the car up for the tires, so basically a smart commercial. But this is all what I see with my data. So that is a problem. So what do we think we want to do, or what do we do right now? We say, hey, we build a trusted platform. We call it My Data is a working title, yeah? So what you think, oh no, not another platform. Everyone wants a platform, yeah? But our platform is simple. It has just two functions. The first function is like a safe, it's a secure, yeah? It's a secure place. You can put your data in and no one gets it. It's good. But what does it, no effect yet, yeah? The second function is it. You can control the data. At any time, you can say who gets access to my data, which I generate. It's pretty simple, pretty good. Most of the best business models are simple, you understand. So we go back to our highly complex scenario. I have a data generator. Data get not sent immediately away to someone else. It gets just first in this idea on the platform, the trusted platform with the two functions. And then the data user can get the data if I, the data owner, decides, yes, you can have my data. So how does this person get the data? Out of that, I mean, why would I share something with you? For example, you want my car. Why should I give you my car? I'm honest, yeah, I don't know you. Maybe you drive like a Ferkel or a pig. Yeah, it's really free translated. You rubbish it full. I want security or I want money for it. I want a benefit. I give you something, usually I want something back. This is how it works in our capitalism. Yeah? It's not I giving you something, I don't know you. So for that, we have applications. So maybe this is a wrong term. Yeah, I warned you. I use terms just really because I'm not an IT person. I call this value-added services, basically, and applications are used in one term. These applications are transparent for the user. Why would you give me your data to me? I have your examples. We're developing this as well. And these services are running on the MyData platform, for example. We have the e-mobile checker. What does the e-mobile checker does? The e-mobile checker is an application who wants your location data. When you drive a combustion engine, a normal car, a fossil car, you drive it, it tracks your location data, and afterwards it can tell you, yes, 80% of your drives you could substitute with an electric car. And it tells you also which vehicle category. So at any time you know what your data is used for. Later on in this application, you can decide who gets this data on. You can decide you want to give it to Volkswagen, Porsche, BMW, whomever. So this is just an example of one of the value-added services. I come later on who could use that. Is you know at any time what is your data used for, and you can control the data. You can decide you give the data to someone or you say, no, stop, that's it. What is your value? The value for you as a user is you know if you could use an electric car. So why should the data user do it, for example, a BMW? For a BMW, it is a legitimate way to get your data. They are not needing this on the page 127, the little cross where say, yeah, behind your back, I grab your data. No, they do it transparent, yeah? Premium car, premium data handling. So we have Blue Park, for example. Blue Park is a telematic-based fleet system, as a, what is it, consultancy, a fleet concept, which makes your, yeah, it's based on telematics, on real-time data, which makes it more clear for example, for an SAP or bigger companies which are more fleets. Here we can optimize them. We need location-based data, not just location-based data, all the different type of data we can have, yeah? So we have here applications. We open this platform for third people, for third-party developers. Of course, this is not as easy as you just develop an application. It needs to be certified by MSG that these applications are safe, yeah? That the applications are not sending data or grabbing data in the background, sending it away. And of course, again, someone needs to control us, yeah? When we are running the platform, we can tell you, oh, we are trusted. Everyone can say this, so we need to be controlled. So we are talking already right now with universities, institutes. It could be also governmental parties which are controlling our platform that we're not grabbing the data and doing, yeah, bad things, I would say, more or less with it, like Apple or Google, what they're doing. Short, you could say, we are the man in the middle. This is what we want to be in the future. We want to be the man in the middle directly after the data generator who gives or who empowers the data owner, the control in a safe place over his data. How we control this data on our platform is with a My Data Manager. What is My Data Manager? It's basically an application we have on a desktop, on a phone, VR glasses, whatever. Okay, the VR glasses was basically, this was a joke, yeah, not as good as other jokes, yeah, not yet. But basically it's just an application which you can control your data with. It's just a surface and you don't use it every day. It's not like a Facebook. I don't want to make your life another thing to check. I don't have a Facebook account. My wife has a Facebook account. Every day in the morning she gets up. Ooh, have you seen? No, I don't have it. I don't want that my data manager is an application like this. You go only into this application when you want to change things, when you're unhappy how your data is used. Good. Everyone is still there, it's shorter and quicker. What do we do? A lot of things, yeah. Before I came to the MSG, I built an electric car, which is now driving in Munich. There are 8 cars driving one from scratch with a single bond. So the lessons which I learned there was you need market feedback, immediately market feedback. When you get the market feedback, this is here the minimum value product. You know what the market needs, you can adjust your business model and can go on. When there is a bad market feedback, then you can stop with it. Yeah, then you don't waste time. So this is one really important thing. You ask the market. It makes no sense when you close the door, develop the greatest things for years and years and years, and the money is just going down the sink. Makes no sense. So we are doing visualizations, we go on exhibitions, we meet partners, we are talking to Bosch, to VW, we're also talking to startups. We're doing a lot of things. Yeah. By the end of the day, end of 2016, we're having a prototype running, and in 2017, we're going live with a platform. This is the importance. I think the rest is, I think every MSG person says, you can meet because probably we can't, yeah, I don't know, but it's all there. A lot of questions what we're having is, and maybe it would be really great if you could help me with the one or the other question, because I have no answer to that, yeah. And we don't know if we will succeed, yeah, with the whole story we're doing here. We are just trying, we are going forward, we are getting market feedback, we are adjusting, we are running further. But we do not know if there's a market acceptance for something like this. I have the feelings that the younger generation, Generation Y, Generation Z, whatever you want to call it, the generations living out there, they give their data away for 20 cents or something, yeah, really, really cheapish, or they do not care. I mean, how many people are using WhatsApp, using Facebook, using all the stuff, as long when you use a service for free, then you are the product. And I don't have the feeling that a lot of young people have this understanding. When you don't pay for something, you pay with your data. Data is a new currency, what you're doing with. So we do not know is there a market for a platform where you can control your data. We also do not know if we would have enough value-added services. The most important is, why should go the B2B, the businesses on our platform? The C's is pretty easy to catch the customers. The customers you get by the end of the day is money. Yeah? It's a, we call it the hedgehog rabbit problem, the eagle problem. Yeah? When you don't have the other one, you do not have the other one. If you would have 1 million customers, then the businesses would come. We don't have 1 million customers, so the business would come, etc. pp. Right now is the problem, when a business with a business makes a business, they talk bilateral, they talk to each other. Why should they do it over our platform? Why should they do that? Yeah? There's no need for it. With a technical implementation, I don't know. Then I need to go to an expert, yeah. But I'm not going so far. I do just the ideation, I do the ideas, what we could do next. So this is what we're also doing, yeah, by the MSG. Then there's also the question, are we allowed to look into the data? Let us assume there's a market for the platform and the people say, yes, we do take care of our data. We want to be in control of our data and we want to generate money with it, or whatever you want to generate with it. What is the value of it? How do you value data? I mean, for example, for Xaba, the data has a different value, my location data, as for you or for you, yeah, or for an insurance company, my pulse is much more worse than for, I don't know, the electric toothbrush producer. So what is the value of data? I have no idea. I'm trying to solve this for 2 weeks. Maybe you have an idea, yeah? Yeah, we need still to look at a viable business model. How does it work? I think a platform like this can only exist and can grow in the big few if the customer does not pay for anything. I think the businesses need to pay for that. It needs to be a service for free. Maybe it is like Google, yeah? I looked around, what do other people do, yeah? You get 10 or 15 gigabytes for free, and then you pay if you need more. Maybe this is like the premium or freemium, I don't know how it's even called, but you get something at the beginning for free and then you pay later on it. So we have no idea how we do that yet, but we're still running as quick as we can, yeah? And also, if it succeeds or when it succeeds, who's actually running the platform? Initially, the MSG is doing it, but in the future, it's for me completely open because I, at least from the point of the Minusphere view out of, we are not running a platform. This is not our business model, what we are doing. So we are almost through. So what is actually the benefit of this platform, yeah? No one needs the pointer, but I'm too shaky from the side, so I do it from the front. We have on the left side the data, and we have in the middle the data generator, the car. The person, which is at the barrier's control, is actually the user. It's me and you, yeah? You control your data. This is he symbolizing. This is the user at the side who's doing it. We are having here all the three different we have here also. A Pedelec or all other things, you generate just data, and all of them are actually producing location-based data. All of them. So why does not all of these data here, which are produced, can be used by all of them? Right now we have we call it Zillow, yeah? The car is producing the location-based data, and only the car manufacturer uses it. If you are participating by our platform, we have a higher efficiency of the data. So because this person here, you and me, we can decide that my location-based data can use the insurance, OEM, banks, and services. So I have a multiple user of my generated data. I also can not just give them my location data of my car, also for my smartwatch, for my smartphone, etc. pp. So I can give actually the data user on the right side a complete profile of my location, of my pulse, of my sleeping, of my eating habits, whatever. We have already a cooperation with a company which is analyzing, which is giving you the same functionality with your browser data. So when I know what you browse, what you're doing in the web, in the World Wide Web, yeah? When I know what you're doing there, and I know what you're doing in the real life, I can combine it. I can add value to data, yeah? Also the car data, when you imagine it a little bit, yeah? It's a driving sensor. When I know what the temperature and the sun is outside, all that stuff, with the solar, with the photovoltaic things we're having outside, we have a difference right now of 6 megawatt of energy outside. So they're switching actually the big energy facilities on or off because they can't predict it proper. When I can predict this with all my driving sensors, we have in Germany, I think 40 million, 42 million cars. I have the best weather forecast in the world. I know where the sun shines, I know where fog is, I know where the Sahara storm is, whatever is. I know it just because I have a sensor, so I can adjust the energy level. So we really believe that here is a possibility just of the data efficiency and all the possibilities you have to share the data, that there's a business model behind it, a market it, but we have difficulties, as you've seen the one slide before, to put it in words and in numbers. And that is basically now your turn, because I would like to hear, hopefully, solutions or ideas how we could solve, or what do you think, where's the biggest value for it, or do you see any further values? Do you think there's a market? Just your feedback, yeah, not just the market feedback, but it would be market feedback is good, but I would be even more happy, yeah, if you could help me with any of them. Who wants to be first?
Well, actually, I want to help you. I want to help you with that. But before, I have three questions.
Okay.
One more. No. The first is, you had a slide in which there was a secure safe.
Yeah.
So I imagine I'm giving you all of my data regarding all of my everything in my life, and you say you have a secure safe, and then I can switch on my TV and see that everyone loses his data, even the NSA, big time. So my first question is, why is this safe?
Because it is my rule, my platform, my rule. Now it needs to be a technical thing, you need to be involved, but I think you can make definitely, it's never 100 persons not existing, even not by an airbag. Yeah, but you can make things for sure safer or more secure than they are right now. Yeah, so this is where I need experts. I don't know how to do it technically, I do not know.
Everyone keeps money in the bank. We know you. There were loads of money stolen from the bank, so a business model could be a bank style or something like that. You understand what I'm saying?
So me? Yes, of course. You can always steal things. Yeah, this is. But I'm not. I'm hoping that the people are more right here and not doing that.
You understand? So I'm saying, as I keep my money in a bank, I don't see any difference to give you my data if you say it's secure.
Oh, thank you very much. I got it in the wrong. Yeah, no, that's very good. I think it's the same. No, there is no safe place in the. Yes, second question.
Yeah, it's kind of the same to the first one. So momentarily, as you had on your slide on the left side. All of my data is distributed in several places. So part of it is in my phone, in my smartwatch, another part of it is in my smartwatch, and so on. And now I'm converging it all into one place, so it can be mixed up and coordinated with and done stuff to it. So is that a good idea? Because if I wanted to rob data, I would now know where to go.
Why are you so close related to the robber? What is wrong with you?
Yeah, well, maybe I have
to. Okay, no, please, don't get me wrong, yeah, but please let's keep the robber by the side. So of course it is better when you have, I think for me, for my opinion, I don't know how you see it, I have my data everywhere, diversified, every lane I want, I don't know where it is, I don't know where it is used or whatever. When it's on one place, I can add value to this data. Yeah. So this is a benefit, I guess. Yeah. Of course, if there comes a guy with a mask and wants to rob it, it's easier.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry, here's one more.
Yeah, sorry, I'm nearly done. The last question is, that's kind of interesting, you said that data is equal to currency. So how much do I get paid for this as a customer?
Thank you very much. Now we're coming to the question, I need your help.
Yeah.
Now this is a question we do not know. I don't know how to generate. I believe just, yeah, it's a quote of mine. It's that the currency in the future, it's data. It's not, I don't know the value of that. I don't know, for you is data, different data, a different value than it is for me or for different people. This is a difficult, but I think right now you don't get anything for it, but there is. So for example, the car which I was building, which is now driving around, yeah? My idea was there to build a car, mobility for free for everyone. And you pay just with the data which you're generating. I got with this idea 25 million together. Yeah, so I do not know, yeah, how is that one, how it works. But in the future, when you are more connected, why do you need to pay with money? Why can you not pay with data? I really believe I might be wrong. Yeah, but I believe in the future that data, paying with your data is also possible. Yes. for a service. For example, you say you give your complete location service, your pulse rate, your shopping behavior, and therefore you get the cap to the supermarket for free. I can imagine this, yes. Or you get, I mean, do you know Payback?
Yes.
Yeah, you get something for free. You pay with your shopping behavior, you pay already with your data. So data is a currency in some content. I don't know how to, yes.
Yeah, how do you make sure that data doesn't go around the platform and get to the companies that the user don't want it to?
That is very difficult, you are right. For example, when we see Google, yeah, Google is already close to the chip producer, they're producing the chip for the smartphone, yeah, they're sitting next behind it. So if you can, it's really ideal here, yeah? You're directly after the data generator. So the model which it is like the man in the middle. So the data gets generated and we get it. For example, Fitbit. Fitbit goes to the Fitbit server. We don't need the data from the Fitbit server. This makes no sense. Because then we have the second one. We don't know what the Fitbit server is doing with the data. So we need to be straight behind it. We have no solution yet for that. Completely. We are producing our own things, we're doing own applications, we're doing things, yeah. We have our own things we are doing that we can guarantee we are straight behind it. But we believe also when you can get a movement into it, yeah, that people demand it, they see that their data is worth something and it comes like a revolution thing, yeah. Yeah, but we do not know this finally. No, you're right. Yeah, it's difficult.
You could have some strict contracts with the data providers that they don't give the data around you, but yeah, that's...
We tried this several times, and all is what they say to us, for example, Bosch or so, is that they're saying, oh, great idea, you can go on our platform. We say, no, we're not going on your platform, we want to be on our platform, we are the platform, yeah? So, and right now, the value which we...
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.